Okay, so one of the things we changed between the first generation of Smartibot boards and the current one was to increase the amount of current available to the DC motors. A lot of the experiments I did on the first board, I found it wasn't putting out enough current. The new board has worked perfectly for everything I've wanted to do with it. We did some experiments to see how much current it could put out without having any trouble, and we connected a big motor to it, and we wired up to the power supply and measured everything, and we found that it could deliver an amp and a half fairly happily. So that made us think, how powerful could it be? You can run this board up to, 9 volts really. 9 volts at an amp is quite a lot of power, and you've got four motor couplings. I wanted to sort of visualize that. So we're trying to build basically a robot that's gonna have four of these big gear motors that I got in the electronics market, and a nice big battery that's at 7.4 volts. I'm hoping that with this robot we're going to be able to carry some quite heavy things and potentially pull some quite heavy things. I guess what I'm really hoping is that it's going to be able to pull one of us. So I've basically taken the motors. I've designed basically the minimum thing that we need to kind of enclose them and to be hopefully strong enough to do the towing. And then we're going to 3D print it on Yannick's Creality Ender 3. He's only got a 0.4 mil nozzle. So I put this into the 3D printing program Cura, and it says 1 day, 1 hour and 52 minutes to print it. And it's gonna use 91 meters of filament. So I really hope it doesn't fail. So we're gonna run it now. It's like 4 o'clock on Wednesday. And so hopefully by 6 o'clock on Thursday, it's gonna be done. And then after that, we're gonna run the wheels, which are gonna take another 11 hours. We have 100 meters of filament. We have enough time, so we're gonna do it. So this worked out beautifully. Really happy with it. And now we're onto the wheels. So it's almost 11 p.m. but this hardware store is still open, which is good because I need some rope to do the towing tomorrow, so hopefully they've got some. This looks like the stuff. I think I'm buying 4 meters. Mm-hmm. Semi kwai. So 4 meters, 4 kwai, so about 50p. Okay, so this is now put together, and except for the elastic bands. Going to have elastic bands. And now we're going to talk about the different ways that it might fail. I think it's going to fail because I think the screw here isn't quite long enough, and so I think the shafts are going to just spin in this coupling. But I do think it's going to tow the chair, actually. And I think if it manages that, I think it's going to be able to carry Ting standing on it. I think this chassis is strong enough.
So my suspicion is we're not going to get enough traction to rubber parts.
Okay, so
that's,
you think
my first suspicion,
the wheels are going to spin?
Yeah, I think so. But
inside the rubber bands, or the rubber bands are going to spin on the ground?
The rubber bands are going to spin on the ground, I suspect.
Okay.
Because they have a much higher surface area in contact with the wheel than with the ground.
Yeah.
So definitely they will spin on the ground, not on the wheel.
Okay, and you think it's because it's not heavy enough?
Yeah, sure.
I think it's quite
so
heavy.
So we can make it heavier.
Yeah, I mean, that's what's good about having this flat platform.
I mean, I think the wheels will spin before the screw slips.
Yannick, do you think the chassis is strong enough to hold Ting if she stands on it?
I think something's going to break. And like I said before, I think it's most likely that the wheel is going to delaminate between the hub and the, what would you call that, the body of the wheel.
Yeah. Yeah, so, okay, so we think that the hub is going to rip out from the rest of the wheel.
But the other possibility is that the wheel could just collapse in on itself. Or it could be that the screws will strip somehow out of the side of the frame.
Oh, these screws hit?
Yeah.
I don't think that's going to happen.
Because there's
there's going to be an overturning moment here, trying to when she stands on it. I don't think that's going to happen. I think the chassis and the motor connections, I think, are really strong. And also, because we printed this with all the layers like this, I think this wall's going to be pretty strong. And it's clamped by, and these got washers.
Yeah,
I think this is pretty strong. Right, let's do it and see what happens. I'm really pleased with how this like disco rubber band tire thing looks. It's sick. The moment of truth. Well, it's powered up. Okay, we're connected.
Okay.
It's moving. I need to reconnect one. But it does work. Tie it to the chair.
Already?
Yeah. Well, we'll start with the chair without someone in it, right?
Alright.
Okay, test number one. Robot here. Okay. We are definitely pulling the chair. We're pulling the chair, but there is definitely some wheel slipping going on the robot. And I think we need to make the robot heavier. Okay, we added some weight. But this is right on the cusp of falling backwards. So, shouldn't have driven backwards. Power supply. Okay, so we don't think we're going to pull Ting on the chair. I mean, we could try, but...
Should we try?
So we're going to try pulling her on this trolley.
Can we pull the trolley? No problem.
Okay. Ting, do you want to get on? What do you think? Do you think it's going to work?
You need to hold
her. You can crouch, then it's probably safer.
Okay. Yes. Now, by the way, I'm 50 kilograms.
Okay.
About 51. So,
okay. Do you have any last wishes?
happy
Californian. Okay. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Wow! Impressive! Oh, I made it! This ball is like...
That's a delivery robot!
Yay! How are you doing so far?
So this is all made of single Smartibot board. All the currents, drive-use motors, no extra electronics, no speed control, literally just a battery and the Smartibot board. And it's transporting a human. Admittedly not that fast, but still. Should we see if it can do me? Do you want to swap?
I think I'm like 60 or something, 65.
Uh-huh. Any last word? Okay.
No. Oh, yeah. Tell my wife and baby that I love them.
Okay.
Mush. Mush. Alright, yeah. You can get it.
Yep.
Yummy. 90 kilos.
We're moving, right?
Yeah. Pulling me very happily.
Okay, definite prospect of robot failure now. We're gonna see if we can stand on the robot itself. And we're gonna start with Evelyn, because she's the lightest.
And then just step on it very evenly. So for this way, just the camera set up.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, she's on. I think it's running.
Oh,
yeah. Cool.
Let's go now.
So it hasn't worked yet. Are you ready? Alright, so I guess if it held you, shall we see if it holds me? Well, it didn't break, did it? We're just going to keep getting heavier.
I'm 50.
Okay. Are you getting?
Yeah.
Hold
on,
guys.
It's
really hard.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, something sounds like it might be breaking.
Too heavy?
I don't know. Do you want to get on again?
Okay. Uh-oh. Sorry.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is 50 kg?
Yeah, 50.
I mean, it's working.
Yeah?
Something's cracking. What do you think that is?
Oh, okay.
Definitely more cracking sounds.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's working.
Yeah.
That was a wheel falling off. Yeah. Well, okay, so 3D printed structure hasn't broken, and motors are powerful.
Yep.
If this was bigger,
yeah,
and I could fit on it more easily, it could transport me slowly.
Yeah.
One Smartibot board, no other electronics.
Let's see how hot our motor
drive is. 7.2 volt battery. So, hot?
No.
Not even hot?
Not even warm.
So given enough power, a bigger battery, mm-hmm. enough current, mm-hmm. bigger motors, with this board on its own, you could probably pull something quite strong. Cool. Well, I'm glad we did that. That was fun.